Hey guys, Kendra Watson here with Ferno EMS. Today I'm going to go over how to properly install the PediMate Plus. So this works for your kids, your patients from 10 pounds to 100 pounds. It is the recommended way to transport your children, again, up to that weight. Okay, so the first thing you're going to do, as you can see, it's in a, I call it the burrito. It's just easy for storage that way. But what you're gonna do is go ahead and remove the Velcro here, and you're gonna lay out your PediMate. Okay, so you'll see all your straps in here that you need to secure it to the gurney and also to the patient. Okay, so once you've done that, make sure you have removed, which I have already done, make sure you have removed the adult patient straps. So your shoulder straps and your waist strap. Okay, once you've done that, you're gonna go ahead and line this up so you can see the smallest, or the part that curves in on the PediMate, is in line where the mattress breaks, where your head frame adjusts up and down. Okay, so once you've done that, you'll notice here, there's a black strap and then there's a large gray strap. So you'll go ahead and remove this, and you're gonna wrap this around your gurney, and you're just gonna secure it in place. Now you have your next strap here. You're gonna do the same with this. So you're gonna wrap this around the gurney. And if you need to loosen it to adjust it, you'll do that. If you need to tighten it at the end, which I need to do, I'll go ahead and do that. Now I will say, if you're using a Stryker gurney, you may or may not have what's called a bracket. And that bracket would be on the back end here, head frame, and that is actually made for the PediMate Plus. It is not necessary, but it is an extra way to keep the PediMate secure onto the head frame part of the cot. And then once you have done that, you'll notice here that you have these smaller gray straps here. So these are actually gonna wrap around the side frame of your cot. So you may or may not have to adjust your, ours are called surface extender, Stryker, your XPS. So what you'll do, you'll adjust as needed. You'll bring that under. And then you'll secure that into place, and then you'll tighten as needed. Okay, you're gonna go ahead and do the same on the other side. So now you'll see that this is properly secured to the gurney. Okay, so now you're gonna notice your other straps here. So I like to compare this to a child's car seat. That's the best way to describe this, the harness setup that we have here. Okay, so you're gonna have the shoulder straps. So the shoulder straps, okay, are gonna go over the shoulders of the child. So this here is your buckling system. So I'm gonna go ahead and undo it so you can see what it looks like. And you're gonna go ahead and secure that right into place. And then you can obviously adjust this piece up here, which the recommended place is right below the clavicle. Now, you'll notice here that there is a random, seems random, black strap that is here. Now this is not required to use when transporting your patient. However, it is an extra restraint that you can use. It's a chest strap. So let's say that your child might be a little smaller and they just need that extra security around the chest, you can use it. Or maybe you just have a real combative child on board and you just need an extra way to kind of keep them, I guess, restrained, secured, you can use this. But if you don't need it, I'd say probably the majority of the time you may not use it. You can just keep it off to the side here. Okay, thank you guys. I hope that was helpful, and stay safe out there.